You don't have to be an athlete to have athlete's foot. That itchy, red, annoying feeling between your toes is actually from a fungus. That's probably gotten there from sweaty socks, and you're basically making the perfect environment for it not just to be there, but to breed like rabbits on Viagra. Well, it's a bad joke. It's part of the reason why you feel like it goes away, but it comes straight back again. So if this is the case for you, chances are you've got what's commonly known as athlete's foot. There are a few things you can do that you might not have tried before to make it calm down and get your feet fresh as daisies again. So on this video, I'm going to give you 5 tips and one bonus tip on the end, which is a little bit costly, but definitely worth the investment. My name is Sarah Jeffries. I'm a registered nurse here in Los Angeles, California, with experience in emergency room nursing and education. So athlete's foot, or tinea pedis, as it's known in the medical field, can be caused by one or many groups of fungus. Now, like I said, our bodies naturally have fungus growing in it, but it's the conditions that we make that makes the fungus on our feet troublesome and overbreed. Tip number 5. First of all, your foot fungus loves an environment that's warm. It thrives on this. So those lovely, cozy, comfy athletic sport shoes with the thick socks, that's a perfect breeding ground. So as often as possible, get your feet out of your shoes and into the cool, fresh air. Tip number 4, moisture. So if your shoes are warm, then next comes the moisture, because feet sweat easily when they're warm in our shoes, and this is another key ingredient to keeping the fungus happy. If you want to make it disappear, you have to make it mad. So don't give it the stuff that it loves, and it loves moisture. So a tip that helps is to never wear damp or sweaty shoes. Make sure your shoes are well aired out and dry before you wear them again. And if you're able to, have a few spare pair that you can rotate with. For example, having a different pair for exercise, a separate pair for dancing, working, whatever else is you do. Tip number 3, darkness. Fungus grows in warm, moist, dark areas. So don't give it the chance. Get your feet out, use flip-flops and sandals as many times as you can, and get some sunlight on those feet. Number 2, wash, wash, wash those feet every day. Wash your shoes regularly and don't give it the chance to hide out in those dark areas of your footwear. And definitely socks are a once per day situation. Put them in the washer at a high temperature while you're trying to get rid of the athlete's foot, because it's going to sterilize the fabric and kill off the fungus. This video is for educational purposes only and not a replacement for medical advice. Tip number 1, diet. Having an unhealthy diet that's high in sugars and refined foods and carbs can make it harder for your body to fight off any infections and invading, overacting funguses. I've said this before for fighting the flu. If you don't feed it the right vitamins and minerals, how do you expect your body to fight off anything invading your immune system? Before I give you the bonus tip, let me know if I missed anything or if you've tried anything that I didn't mention. So, bonus tip. These are a few temporary measures, but they definitely help with the 5 tips that I just gave you. They're a little bit costly, but I say it's worth it if you're trying to get rid of this fungus forever. So these are fast remedies. Over-the-counter creams and powders, you can get them at your local pharmacy. Always check with your doctor first if you've never used it before. Also, you can try apple cider vinegar. It's like a foot soak. Mix it with some water and see if it helps. Click here and watch this video next, where I talk about anxiety and depression. So click here, this video can really help.